Welcome back to Heat, and it is now time.
What time is it?
For our main event.
The following is a triple threat elimination match for a future World Tag Team Championship match. Introducing first, at a combined weight of 445 pounds from Panama City, Florida, Antonio and Romeo, the Heartthrobs.
And Coach, speaking with the Heartthrobs earlier this week, they told me that, yes, they enjoy entertaining the crowd. They enjoy making people smile. They certainly enjoy entertaining the ladies, but they want to be taken seriously. And in order to do that, they need a win tonight. Of course, if they do get it, they'll get that title shot against Kane in the Big Show.
And making their way to the ring at combined weight of 585 pounds, the team of Tyson, Tomko, and Snitsky.
If I was to handicap this match and say, who do I think my favorites would be, I think it would be these two, simply because I think they've been teaming up longer than Val Venus and Viscera. I'm not going to discount the Heartthrobs, but these two guys are big, they're nasty, and when they have their game faces on, they're very dangerous.
Well, let's make no mistake about it. The Heartthrobs are the underdogs in this match, that's for sure. Everyone can agree on that. But what a night, what an opportunity it is for all three of these tag teams.
And making their way to the ring, the team of Viscera and Val Venus.
And real quick before we get this match started, you seem pretty excited about the opportunity that Mick Foley is now the guest referee in that huge John Cena Edge Championship match for the WWE title this coming week on Raw. How is that fair for Edge? How is that even remotely fair for Edge?
Why is it not? You don't think that Mick Foley's going to call it right down the middle?
No, I don't. I think Mick Foley has his favorites. He likes the kids. John Cena likes the kids. I think, you know, that's why John Cena picked Mick Foley to be the guest referee. I really do.
Because he likes the kids?
The fan favorites. Mick Foley loves the kids. He writes kid books. Follow me here.
I don't understand what that has to do with calling a wrestling match right down the middle.
I'm saying he likes people that are the same as him. Why can't you follow this with me? John Cena is the same as Mick Foley. He likes entertaining the kids. Why don't I explain my points? They're very simple.
Wait a minute.
Well, we know Val Venus won't find her in the crowd.
Wow, that may have been the most attractive female fan Val Venus has seen in some time. My goodness.
Well, we can see how maybe serious Val Venus is about this match. Yeah. He didn't even go out to give anybody the towel.
Maybe it is Val Venus's lucky night. And luck certainly will play a part in this match. Three tag teams, one world tag team title shot opportunity on the line. And it is elimination style, Coach. One team will be ejected.
Oh. Well, one team's going to be eliminated very quickly. And Val Venus apparently wasn't the man that was going to start. He said, hello, with the foot.
It'll be Antonio and Snitsky. I don't mean to laugh because certainly that hurt, but it came out of nowhere, and Val Venus hopefully is still with us.
Well, that shows that Snitsky doesn't care who he hits as long as he just hits somebody.
And wait a minute. We know all about Snitsky's fetishes, and he likes that boa a little too much. And the Heartthrobs take an opportunity to do a standing drop kick. And whoa! Look out, Tomko out of the ring. And Coach, hey, the Heartthrobs were my guests this week on WWE.com's Bite This. They had a dating show, they were very entertaining, and it looks like they're performing a little better since they had Todd Grisham contact.
Well, I'm not gonna say what that sounded like. I'm gonna leave that alone, but I will say this. The Heartthrobs do have great personalities. They like the ladies. I know you had a little date contest. I don't know what that was all about, but obviously the Heartthrobs have come ready to play this week.
Oh, and Romeo trying a crossbody. Didn't work out as planned. Oh, what was that? The Throbs may be done. They are. It's over. The Heartthrobs have been eliminated. So now we're down to Tyson, Tomko, and Snitsky versus Val Venus and Viscera when we return. Welcome back. We are in the midst of a triple threat tag team match for a future title shot for the World Tag Team Championship. Hold on, a cover here from Big Miss. No. Coach, we started with three teams. We're down to two.
And Val Venus and Viscera came fired up during the break. Snitsky and Tomko were very happy with their initial win over the Heartthrobs, but now they need to concentrate on Valvinus and Big Vince.
So the Heartthrobs are out, and now it's just basically a regular tag team match as Viscera is just throwing Snitsky around like he weighs 50 pounds, and now out goes Venus.
Well, you can see how much that hurt, but Grisham, this is far from a regular tag team match because the opportunity that is on the line is huge for both of these teams.
Snitsky now going to get the legal man, Valvinus, and toss him back into the ring, which is exactly what he does. And boy, the dynamic now has really taken a step up, Coach. You can tell all four of these superstars want this win in the worst way.
Well, they want the win, especially right now. Because when you're on the road to WrestleMania and you get a shot at the World Tag Team titles in the future, if they can defeat the Big Show and Kane somehow, you'd have to believe that one of these two teams would be on WrestleMania.
And let's think about this. There, you can't replace Big Show and Kane as far as size and power, but this is a good little practice match, so to speak, for Valvinus and Viscera should they win, because Tomko and Snitsky are about as close as you can come to those two huge superstars.
I love how you undersell things. A good little match. Both of these teams are fantastic.
2-0.
They're big. They're strong. There's nothing little about this match at all.
There's nothing little about the match. All I'm saying is, in order to beat Big Show and Kane, it's going to take a monumental performance.
It will take a performance of a lifetime, no doubt about it. You're absolutely right.
No one's been able to do it for, what, 5 months now?
When they won the tag team titles, you knew that they were going to hold on to them for a very long time because they're hard enough to beat one-on-one, let alone when they're both in there.
And no one's even come close to knocking off Kane and the Big Show during their World Tag Team title run. One of these two teams will get a shot, though. And right now, it appears that Valvinus and Viscera have the edge. But just as I say that, Snitsky's got Venus in a bear hug.
Yeah, Valvinus trying to use his speed and quickness. Snitsky obviously using his power to try to suck the wind out of Valvinus.
Snitsky wrenching away now. The oxygen has to be fleeting surely now for Venus.
And there's nothing Big Vince can do over there but stand and look and hope that somehow Valvinus can get out and tag him in.
Can you imagine if Snitsky were to squeeze me that hard, my ribs would explode out of my body.
I would love to see anybody squeeze you that hard. Maybe you'd be off the show for a couple of weeks.
A big chop there from Venus, and now from a bear hug to a sleeper hold. But Viz, oh my, look at that! How did Valvinus find the energy to pull that move off?
Well, it was all the energy he had left, because you can see now he can't get up. He definitely needs to tag in Big Viz, and Snitsky, quite frankly, needs a tag as well.
Venus inching ever so close to the big fellow. Tom goes in, and no, Venus can't quite reach Viscera. The Enziguri coach.
Well, Valvinus is pulling every stop out that he has because he needs to get out and recoup and get a fresh Big Viz in. But you can see once and now twice. Oh boy.
A headbutt from Snitsky. Venus through the legs, and he's made the tag. And here comes Big Viscera clothesline. A back elbow. Headbutt again. Snitsky's down. Top goes up. Wow.
Come on, Pop.
Well, you can see Big Viz is very fresh and very mean. And oh, no. No, we're not. I don't want to see this. Apparently the crowd wants to see it.
Viscera letting Snitsky know what's coming. Oh, and Tomko interrupts the party. And now all four superstars are in the ring. And referee Chad Patton needs to get some sort of order happening here. Let's remember Snitsky and Viscera are the legal men.
Oh no.
This is not good. Clothesline from Venus. Viscera's calling for some fan interaction. He's getting it.
And these fans are starting to get on their feet. They're getting behind Big Viz and Valvinus.
Clear! Viscera bringing the house, literally. Tom goes out. Our two legal men, Viscera and Snitsky, are in the ring. Oh! A Samoan drop. Here it comes. Shot! No! The Viscera drop! It's gotta be over! It has to be! It is! a title shot this week. It's John Cena versus Edge on Raw. Mick Foley, your special guest referee. Plus, the semifinals on the road to WrestleMania tournament. For the coach, I'm Todd Grisham. Thanks for watching, Heat.